Another giant chromosomes, or these are also called a special chromosome, which is known as the B chromosome. So you can see here the pictures wherein we have shown how the B chromosome appear. So the A chromosome set specific to particular species are also called as a primary chromosome. Okay, that is to say that all the species have a primary chromosome, and that primary chromosome is represented as the A, but B chromosome is rare. You don't find it in all the organisms. So the supernumerary chromosome are the additional or extra chromosomal set present in a set. What are the supernumerary chromosome we are talking about is this B chromosome, which is an extra chromosomal set which is present in the set. So this type of chromosome, that is the B chromosomes, are seen in hundreds of animal species, particularly in grasshopper and 600 plant species, for example, in maize plant. And especially fungi also contain the supernumerary, or it is also called as the B chromosome. And the number of the B chromosomes present in these species varies. These chromosomes are majority, they are heterochromatic, and they are largely non-coding regions. They do not code, they don't have a coding regions. So the B chromosomes are predicted to be evolved from the heterochromatic segment of the normal chromosome and are non-dividing chromosome. So we told you know that there are heterochromatids and euchromatids. Heterochromatids means you know that they are uncoiled, they are very tightly bound regions. So whenever they are tightly bound, we have always told that they are inactive. So what the scientists have told that these B chromosomes have, maybe they have evolved from the heterochromatic segments. That is your normal chromosomes, that is your A chromosomes, they also have the heterochromatids and euchromatids. So maybe they have been, these B chromosomes are derived from the heterochromatic region of from the A chromosomes, and that is why they are also non-dividing chromosome, because they are highly coiled. So example of this supernumerary chromosome in fungi, they do not carry the genes that are necessary for basic fungal growth, but may have some functional significance. So it is they what they mean to tell is, for a normal growth of fungi, maybe it is not necessary to have this B chromosome, but definitely they may be having some functional significance. So 90% of these B chromosome tend to lack the centromere. Now you know what is the centromere, okay, which is holding the arms of your chromatids, are known as the centromere, and these B chromosome 90% lack the centromere. The occurrence of these chromosomes vary according to the environmental condition, increases in the warm and dry environment, but are absent and rare in the cooler localities. So this is another features of the B chromosome. So there is evidence of deleterious effect of supernumeraries on the pollen fertility. That is, they have observed that, we have told that there are many plant species, like about 600 plant species are expected to have this B chromosome, and they have found that these chromosomes have an effect on the pollen fertility, that is, they make the pollen infertile. The B chromosome suppresses the synapses. What is the synapses means? The pairing of the homologous chromosome occurs in the meiosis, that is known as the synapses. So, which reduces the multiple pairing between the homologous chromosomes in the allopolyploidy. So, they have seen that the negative effect of these B chromosomes, because they suppress the synapses and reduce the fertility of the particular plant in which they are present. So this is about the B chromosome.